Welcome to Dirty Files. I am very happy to present you the content I have prepared in the genres: true crimes, cold files, serial killers, and many more. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and to stay tuned for more of this content. Here we go. Are you ready to discover the horrific story of Richard Scott Baumhammers, who killed 5 people and injured many more in an ethnically motivated shooting in Pittsburgh? Richard Scott Baumhammers. In Pittsburgh, a racist immigration lawyer gave an ethnic motive while shooting for 1 hour, killing 5 people in total in 4 different places. The victims identified are a Jewish woman, an Indian grocer, 2 Asian employees of Chinese restaurant, and an African-American man of karate school. Another Indian man was also injured severely. He is in critical condition. The main perpetrator, Richard Scott Baumhammers of 34 years of age, allegedly wished to create a political party in order to fight immigrants, and is not surprising he had an unspecified mental issues that forced him to be hospitalized on his own several days before. The shootings occurred within the war zone, having been done in an area of approximately 20 miles radiating through suburbs around Pittsburgh. Baumhammers used a .357 caliber handgun in the carnage. Police initially attended the scene of a small fire at the house of another of Baumhammers' relatives, Anita Gordon, in the suburban Mount Lebanon. The victim, identified as 63-year-old Ira Gordon, died of unknown causes inside the house. He's happy that she's alive, and as far as the wound on her chest, that she was shot several times. Likely to have died of a heart attack, Gordon was shot dead by Baumhammers, who was known to him since childhood. The latter allegedly set a small fire at the house. Baumhammers' next attack was at the Beth El Congregation Synagogue, where he fired some more rounds through the windows and spray painted the word Jew on the exterior entrance and the swastikas on the walls outside. He then continued the shooting spree at an Indian grocery store in Carnegie and fatally shot Anil Thakur, a 31-year-old, and leaving Sundy Patel gravely injured at the age of 25. This was according to the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette, where he was shot in the neck with the likelihood of being paralyzed for the rest of his life. Talim Azmi, an eyewitness and the owner of the travel agency opposite to the Indian grocery store, stated, "Baumhammers came out of the shop, concealed the gun, and got into his car. He sat for maybe 5 or 10 seconds without attempting anything or disrupting anything, and in a very cool, composed manner menacingly produced it as if he was pulling a gun after purchasing a bag of groceries," Kretzler said. He also shot another drive-by on a synagogue in Carnegie before proceeding to Yarfe Chinese cuisine restaurant, where he fatally shot Tao Pham, a 30-year-old Vietnamese-born delivery man of the restaurant, and Ji Sun, the 34-year-old Chinese restaurant owner. Approximately in 15 minutes, a shooting rampage took place inside a karate school that is located in a shopping plaza, where he killed 22-year-old Gary Lee. On May 18, Baumhammers was committed for trial and ruled by jury that he was unfit to stand trial and was ordered to be committed to Mayview State Hospital for observation and treatment. Commonwealth Judge Lawrence O'Toole said that Baumhammers was incompetent to undertake the role of assisting his defense counsel in the homicide charges facing him, but he can be recommitted for further trial when he becomes competent. This is true. A 34-year-old former immigrant lawyer, Baumhammers was charged for killing 5 people and attempted murder of a 6th person in Allegheny and Beaver in April 28. There is a long list of his victims that included Jews, Indians, Vietnamese, Chinese, and blacks. On May 18, Baumhammers was committed for trial and ruled by jury that he was unfit to stand trial and was ordered to be committed to Mayview State Hospital for observation and treatment. Commonwealth Judge Lawrence O'Toole said that Baumhammers was incompetent to undertake the role of assisting his defense counsel in the homicide charges facing him, but he can be recommitted for further trial when he becomes competent. This is true. A 34-year-old former immigrant lawyer, Baumhammers was charged for killing 5 people and attempted murder of a 6th person in Allegheny and Beaver in April 28. There is a long list of his victims that included Jews, Indians, Vietnamese, Chinese, and blacks. Baumhammers, another Latvian whose family was a refugee in the U.S., operated the website that advocated for European immigrants' rights over the Third World. One of the psychiatrists who personally interviewed Baumhammers at the criminal site pointed that he had an eerie emotional affect and was paranoid regarding his belief that he was a victim of poisoning during his visits to Europe. He and 2 other psychiatrists testified that it was impossible to have Baumhammers undergo trial since he was mentally mad. Richard Baumhammers was born in Pittsburgh to Andres and Anise Baumhammers. He father and mother were Lutheran Latvian who escaped from the Soviet invasion in Latvia. Both parents would go on to become faculty members for the University of Pittsburgh School of Dental Medicine and establish a thriving dental practice at 6121 Fifth Avenue adjacent to the university campus. Baumhammers was born at Cesis, Latvian SSR, which was a part of the Soviet Union. He was the 2nd child of Andres and Anise Baumhammers. His elder sister was Dana, born in 1963. The family relocated and permanently together in the town of MT Lebanon, which is in the outskirts of Pittsburgh City. To the best of knowledge, so far, so good. Both Richard and Dana were students of MT Lebanon High School and seemed to have a positive academic performance. Richard was one of those players sitting on the bench and performing as a backup kicker for the MT Lebanon High School football team. It also transformed Dana Baumhammer's pack into a member of the medical faculty at the campus of Johns Hopkins University in Baltimore, Maryland. In 1983, Baumhammer's finished high school and 4 years later, he graduated from Kent State University in Ohio. In 1989, he started studying law at Cumberland Law School in Birmingham, Alabama. A former Cumberland classmate said Baumhammers was friendly, a scholar, in the upper echelon of his class. After finishing at Cumberland, Baumhammers pursued a year-long postgraduate international program in at the University of the Pacific's McGeorge School of Law in Sacramento, California, earning a master's degree in transnational business practice, in immigration law and international law. Baumhammers and his wife stayed in Atlanta, Georgia for several years starting from mid-1990s and during this time as the international law section member of the Georgia Bar Association. He was an active member as of March 2000 and decided to become a passive member on October 2005. The suspect, Richard Baumhammers, moved back to Pittsburgh from California in the late 1990s due to psychiatric issues, and he began living with his parents. The defense noted that Baumhammers had been receiving treatment for mental ailments since 1993 and that he had been certified insane, thereby being a voluntary patient in a mental health ward not less than 2 times. Andres, his father, later conceded to having noted symptoms of mental illness in Richard from age 4. Or he constantly thought that his face was burnt by the sun. Nevertheless, dermatologists assured Baumhammers that his skin is evidently perfectly normal. Baumhammers was for Europe in a vacation in 1993. His father was astounded on his return, not only due to his physical appearance but also his state of mind. Baumhammers stated in his trial that Richard informed him that during a visit to Ukraine he was high, and it would be different when he was in Finland because he thought that people were coming after him. He mentioned later in the trial that his father also said Richard told him and his wife that he could no longer talk to them directly due to FBI surveillance of the house. Baumhammers testified that his parents wanted to go to the basement to have a word with him and that their oral communication was not acceptable to him and suggested that they used a pen and a piece of paper. The evidence provided by Andres Baumhammer stated that no less Richard wanted to be taken to Dr. Kevorkian in order to commit suicide. Richard Baumhammer's records. The man charged with the mass shooting, Richard Baumhammers, admitted himself to the Western Psychiatric Hospital in Pittsburgh and was diagnosed by Dr. Matt Sherry Keshvan of suffering from a delusional disorder of the persecutional type. Baumhammers would spend the following years attending to 8 psychiatrists, 4 clinical psychologists, and attempt 16 different drugs. Several years ago, after being paroled, Baumhammers resided in a house of parents in MT, Lebanon. He was a member of the Allegheny County Bar Association, and he decided to discontinue such membership in 1999. Baumhammers. In 1997, the now unemployed Baumhammers visited Riga, Latvia, in which he states he lived at the KR. It was Barona Avenue, just a block or two from 5106 Colorado Street, where his grandparents had resided in mid-1937. He obtained Latvian citizenship and later on went looking for some of the family houses that were grabbed during the Soviets' invasion of Latvia. He made a claim under Latvia's denationalization process when he could no longer hold the shares of the company for the Latvian government after the collapse of the USSR, but he was too late. All claims must have been filed by 1996. At least, that is what some of the people whom Baumhammers interacted with in Latvia observed about him. From far and wide, Baumhammers stayed to himself, and if he mingled, he seemed to be at home surrounded by native Latvians and a couple of other foreign Latvian Americans. They didn't see the violent side Baumhammers or heard him utter a racist sentiment, and there is no police record of Baumhammers in Latvia. However, some of the Latvian people that I met stated that Baumhammers was intent on meeting women but was shy. However, in the fall of 1999, Baumhammers was arrested in Paris, France for hitting a 50-year-old female bartender named Viviane Le Garrick, saying he thought she was Jewish.
Le Garrick statement.
Baumhammers then stated to the arresting officers and Le Garrick that he was mentally ill. The police then took Baumhammers to the parish's Hotel du Psychiatric Ward for a few hours for an assessment. Then he was detained at a station. And by the end of week, he got onto a plane to Spain. 2 days later, on April 27, 1999, Baumhammers would purchase a. Police found a .357 Magnum revolver at the crime scene in South Strabane Township, Pennsylvania. Friday, April 28, 2000. At 1:30 p.m. EST, Baumhammers went to his next-door neighbor's house where a 53-year-old Jewish lady named Nikki Gordon lived and executed her before setting her house ablaze. Gordon had known Baumhammers' parents for 31 years, a big consolation towards the current ordeal. Later, Baumhammers proceeded to follow Gordon to the Beth El congregation in Scott Township and murder him in his car, a black Jeep Cherokee. There, he shot inside the windows of the synagogue. He also got out of his car and used red paint to draw 2 swastikas on the building. Just about several doors down from the Jewish place of worship in Scott Town Center at the India Grocer Store, 31-year-old Anil Thakur, who is originally from Bihar, India, was shot dead by robbers while taking a lunch break to pick up some groceries. One client, a 25-year-old store manager Sandeep Patel, happened to be shot in the neck that left him paralyzed. Patel was paralyzed for the next 7 years. He succumbed to death on February 2007 at UPMC in McCandless, Pennsylvania, due to complications of pneumonia at the age of 32. Baumhammers then proceeded to the Ahavath Akim congregation in Carnegie and opened gunfire at the synagogue's window, breaking all the glass. At Robinson Town Center, about 10 miles from his home, he went to Yafei Chinese Cuisine where Asian Americans, manager, G. Sun, 34 years old, and Vietnamese America cook, 27-year-old Theo Pham, was killed before his customers. Leaving Robinson Town Center, Baumhammers proceeded to the C.S. Kim School of Karate in Center Township, Beaver County, where 22-year Gary Lee, an African American, was exercising with a fellow European American friend, George Thomas II. Baumhammers first attempted to shoot Thomas with the gun, though she ended up turning around to shoot Lee, who died upon impact. Richard Baumhammers was pulled over in his Jeep and arrested at 3. Meantime, the Merthorp family calmly sat and watched 9 p.m. local time or 3 a.m. In the morning from the comfort of their seat in Ambridge, Pennsylvania, Baumhammers were killing for 2 hours and killed in 15 miles tract that spanned 3 different towns. There are 19 charges for Richard Baumhammers, and these are summarized as follows. 8 charges of ethnic intimidation, 2 charges of arson, 2 charges of criminal mischief, 1 of arson, 1 of reckless endangerment to another person, 1 violation of the Uniform Firearms Act, 2 for vandalism of institution, 1 aggravated assault, and 1 attempt to commit a crime and 5 counts of murder. Pittsburgh police officers who searched the house in MT Lebanon, which Baumhammers and his wife rented, recovered the document called the Free Market Party, authored by Baumhammers and which resembled a manifesto, though it was not formally so. It listed Baumhammers as the chairman. He complains of the phenomenon where white European Americans are being outnumbered by African Americans, Mexican, and other immigrants. Baumhammers had also posted a website dedicated to the proposition that it is time to stop non-white immigration. In a statement on the website, he said that 99% of today's immigration is non-European. In early May 2000, Common Pleas Judge of Allegheny County, Lawrence J. O'Toole, agreed to Baumhammer's claim of insanity, and thus the man had to spend at least 90 days in a psychiatric facility. 3 doctors evaluated Baumhammer's before O'Toole concluded that he was unfit to stand trial. All the psychiatrists agreed that Baumhammer's was mentally ill, but each provided a distinct diagnosis. While one witness stated that Baumhammer's was paranoid schizophrenic, another witness stated that Baumhammer's had psychotic thought disorder, and the third one testified that he had delusional disorder. As it was pointed out earlier, the man, known as Richard Baumhammer's, was arrested on May 1, 2000 on the charges including homicide, arson, and racially motivated hate crimes. He was handcuffed and charged, and the authorities placed a $1 million bond on him. On May 9, 2001, the jury delivered its verdict where Baumhammer's was established to be guilty on all the 19 counts. 2 days later, on the May 11, 2001, and in a 20-minute deliberation, the same jury demanded that Baumhammer's should be put to death for his criminal acts. Baumhammer's is also to die by lethal injection, and is at the moment in death row at Green State Correctional awaiting appeals at Institute in Waynesburg, Pennsylvania. If you like this tragic story, don't forget to subscribe to discover the dark corners of history and stay up to date. Goodbye to meet again with more interesting content.